Big action coming your way in the form of the Fantastic Four, a staple in comic books since debuting in 1961.
And Marvel's First Family has been given a contemporary reimagining as a group of outsiders with newfound powers must band together in order to save the world.
You're watching Made in Hollywood. Now here's the scene from Fantastic Four.
I want you to meet my daughter, Sue.
You want to be famous?
I just want my work to make a difference.
John, Reed.
This guy doesn't take orders well.
Yeah, especially from people who say, I don't take orders well.
Don't let any of these lab coats give you any crap, all right?
Well, if I do, I know who to call. The muscle.
I gotta say, it's fun having you here.
Really?
No.
What you've created here is incredible.
The story is different, it's a reimagining, and your characters have a lot of the same traits, of course, because they're based off of the same characters, but you didn't necessarily recreate the characters that the original cast created. So they have their own personalities, their own characteristics. What did you want to do differently with each of your characters?
The film is, you know, is the director's vision. So tonally, he had a specific vision for each character, for how they would be portrayed, you know, tonally, how you wanted everything to feel. So that alone, you know, as when the director changes, the entire movie changes, you know what I'm saying? So that's kind of followed his lead.
We wanted to do everything differently, I think, right?
They just cracked interdimensional travel.
Incredible.
This isn't a remake. I've done a film before that was it was 100% a remake of an original, but this is a reboot, you know, and they do that in, you know, in theater a lot. They'll kind of, you know, reboot something, and so it's called a revival. And yeah, hopefully you're kind of bringing something to it that is, you know, different and unique, and we absolutely did a complete 180 from the last one in terms of our tone.
This version, you know, in the origin is less that he's all powerful and all arrogant and all. He's a guy who's been told he's a genius and told he's bright and has these fantastic ideas. Fantastic. And then the politics of it all and the BS make sure that it doesn't come to fruition. The arrogance grows from the actual combatants between him and Reed.
All I want to know is where are my children?
Four have survived. All exhibit unique physical conditions.
I just want to fix my friends.
You can't fix this.
You should use these powers to help people.
I always thought that the Fantastic Four were a little less fortunate in the powers that they gained because they kind of just got, however the accident happened, that, you know, he became.
Whose power do you think is the coolest and whose do you think is the lamest?
So I've thought about this. I would definitely want the Invisible Woman's power because I always wanted that as a kid. I always thought it'd be really fun to be invisible because you can go into the store and go shopping.
Oh, yeah, of course.
So you want to shoplift? You want to shoplift? That's what you're saying.
Well, as a kid, you don't realize that may be bad, and then in
wish
class,
I could go in the store and not pay for stuff.
I wouldn't want to be the thing because you can't. Like, how do you grab things?
How do you give and receive love?
You open the door. You don't know how to close. You don't know anything about what's coming.
What is coming?
Doom.
I would love to ask you about the set, specifically the lab, because it's so cool. I think the reason why I like Marvel movies so much is that it's based in science and technology.
Right.
And you have these really awesome sets that you can't help but feel super genius when you walk onto a set like that, right?
Really? Yeah, I mean, yeah, to a degree. But the sets are so much fun. I mean, this film was the first time I feel in my career that's been very short that felt like the thing I'd always hoped it would feel like when I was a kid, which is coming onto big sets where there's these big machines and they all run and they operate and the lights turn on and they go off, and it felt that way.
The quantum gate, that was cool, and that was fully functional. We could get in, the doors closed, and you know, everything. That was a pretty big set.
If we do this, we do it our way.
A lot of green screen, so whatever you saw now, we didn't see when we were actually filming. So that's the kind of
that's the kind of thing that you don't know what it looks like.
Exactly.
You haven't seen the video.
No, well, exactly. But from the trailer and stuff like that, I mean, you can get a gist of the world and whatnot. But you know, when we were actually filming it, it wasn't that fantastical because you were looking at you know huge green screen drapes.
If you want to stop him, it's gonna take everything you have.
If you guys, well, I guess you guys are a team, but not as your characters, but in real life, just the four of you, had a team name, what would the team name be?
I don't know.
I got nothing.
The underachievers.
The underachievers?
I'm speaking about the moment right now that we can't.
Yeah.
Be specific, yeah.